Today, I'll present a lecture that I talked about back in the 2019 ESRA Congress in Bilbao, Spain. It was my first visit to Bilbao. The city gave me an unforgettable memory. The Bilbao is situated in the north central part of Spain. The city is surrounded by green mountains. Most of all, I cannot forget the beauty of the curvy titanium-clad building, Guggenheim Museum Bilbao. The city seemed to be so cozy and lovely. My assigned topic in the Congress was the title of cons in the diagnostic block in chronic pain. Let me continue to talk about the positive effect of the diagnostic block first. I must admit that diagnostic block have significantly contributed to the elucidation of the spinal pain, and it has led pain physicians to do logical pain practice. Without the diagnostic block, we even could not appreciate discogenic pain, facet joint, and SI joint pain. Therefore, the diagnostic block has been an essential part of pain interventional practice, and most pain organizations have recommended diagnostic block for the more invasive procedures. For example, a diagnostic block of the medial branch block could justify radiofrequency treatment for facet joint pain. In MSK and spine, I believe there are three different diagnostic approaches in MSK and spine pain. I want to put the diagnostic technique into pain-focused diagnostic method out of three categories. Let's think more about three different diagnostic approaches and choose what category you are in. When you have a chronic back pain patient, you will make history, evaluate the dynamic factors, and do a physical examination, check X-ray, and sometimes MRI scans. What is in your mind after all these studies? Does the morphology of the disc and spinal canal bother you? I see mild instability at the L4-5 segment on X-ray and mild black disc protrusion with spinal stenosis at L4-5 level on MRI. I can accentuate segmental instability by the flexion and extension movement. Which one do you consider first? In the past, we may make a hasty decision to HMP or spinal stenosis for the cause of chronic spinal pain. With the help of diagnostic blocks, we can currently extend the vision of diagnosis such as discogenic pain or facet joint pain. Traditional doctors seek the cause of pain in the pathologies such as HMP, facet joint osteoarthritis. Current pain interventionists look for pain generator with diagnostic techniques, but most doctors haven't considered functional focused diagnosis. I want to talk more about functional focus diagnosis later. Let's review the diagnostic block method first. We adopted Koch's postulation for elucidate the spinal pain. The pain generators can be differentiated by the innervation of each component of the spinal segment. I could block the pain if I anesthetize the supplying nerves. For example, two adjacent medial branches supply the facet joint. So, medial branch block with a small volume of local anesthetics confirms the facet joint pain. But there are possible errors of medial branch block. In clinical practice, most pain physicians use local anesthetics of more than 0.5 millimeter, which is enough to block lateral branches. The lateral branch supplies the erect spinal muscle group. So, we cannot exclude the muscle pain with the medial branch block. Also, many doctors do not use contrast media to exclude vascular leaking. which lead to a false negative result. The therapeutic medial branch block can provide short-term pain relief, and of course, the side effect is not long-lasting. The radiofrequency denervation increased the long-term pain relief, a maximum of 2 years. Consequently, the side effects are more severe and more prolonged last than a simple block. A diagnostic block is essential for this invasive technique, which justifies this invasive procedure. We must remember that diagnostic block has a drawback and lead to RLF complications. Medial branch radiofrequency denervation also damages the muscular branches and sensory branches like a proprioceptor of the ligaments. In much chronic nociceptive pain is not a simple MSK pain, but complex neuropathic pain. For example, about 20% of knee pain have neuropathic component. In addition, there is a high instance of neuropathic component in spinal pain. Therefore, denervation can only destroy the sensory nerve without improving symptoms. If you review most published journals regarding the RLF facet procedure, the recipient were young. We must give them more chance to overcome the pain by vigorous exercise for the young patients. The radiofrequency sacrifices muscle and proprioceptive sensory fibers for only 2 year pain relief. It is a situation of penny wise and pound foolish. Thank you for your attention. I'll be back soon.